Hello, it's Mr. Sorpaas here with another random video. I believe that there are people who are thinking of switching to Blender from some other software, and then we have people who are planning to switch away from Blender to something else. I am kind of Blender believer myself, so this video is slightly biased, but anyways, I collected for us some points why I believe that Blender is eventually going to be the future of 3D industry. That is not going to happen very fast, but at this moment it seems that we are slowly going there, and I will show you the evidence I've found so far. But let's focus a little bit to my own background first. I started learning 3D with software called 3D Studio Max. It was a time when there was a huge hype wave around computer graphics. At the top of that huge wave, there was one alone surfer, Autodesk, with their highly popular professional 3D modeling software, 3ds Max and Maya. No one was questioning their autocracy. Lightwave was already dying, and procedural modeling as we see in Houdini was still a little bit too sci-fi for most of the 3D users. I was just a kid when I borrowed from the library a book about Maya, and there was an image of a fish swimming in the Greek water. I was really impressed of that image. I think that was one of my turning points when I started thinking that I really wanna learn 3D modeling. After some research, I however was able to figure out that I never have enough money to buy Maya and start learning it. There was a free version of 3ds Max, but it was only for game designers, and there was no render engine, and I really wanted to do rendering. Some people downloaded the illegal versions of the professional softwares and started using those, but I wasn't like them. I wanted to have the genuine copy of the software I am using, so they were the generation who started with Max and Maya, the pirated versions of those, but I had my own reasons to go to Blender, even when everyone who knew something about 3D modeling were just lauding Blender and saying it to be very bad. Well, it wasn't very good, and there was only few people who knew anything about it. It was a time when if you went to YouTube and searched with name Blender, you found only test renders with monkey head or something with cube. But I needed a cheap alternative, and this was it. I didn't like Blender very much, but there was no other programs, so I started using it. Later I of course learned to love it and the community around it. That was my background in nutshell why I use Blender. Let's go back to the topic. Google has some good tools that helps us to check how popular things are on the internet searches made with Google search engine. The tool I'm using is called Google Trends. It seems that 3ds Max was at 2004 almost as popular in Google searches than Walt Disney himself, but Max has been going down since 2004. Meanwhile, Walt Disney has been staying popular. Now, if we replace Walt Disney with Autodesk Maya, we will see that Maya is doing the same thing as Max, going down. So, why is this happening? Why are the market leaders going down? I think it's because they are not anymore the only option if you wanna do 3D modeling. There's a growing amount of other softwares that are sharing the market with them. Now let's add Blender here also to see how it's going against the giant. It seems that 2015 Blender became more popular than 3D Studio Max or Maya in worldwide statistics. But if we look only United States statistics, we can see that it happened there 5 years before, and rest of the world were just following them with this trend. When I was talking about the generation who started with pirated version of Max and Maya and who are now their professional users, we can now see that at this moment we have a new generation of users who are starting with Blender instead. It means that in the future they will be the professional users of Blender. There is in Netherlands one man who is so stubborn that he is not going to give up when he once started doing something. His name is Ton Rosendahl, and he decided that he is going to do a good 3D modeling software, and he is still working with it. It was a slow start, but because he didn't give up, Blender was all the time getting better and better, and more people started slowly getting interested of it. It means not only more users, but also more developers, and even movie studios who start using Blender in their projects. They also start funding Blender development because Blender is very agile and is listening their ideas. And that means even faster development. No commercial software house can follow this. It's very hard to see why would this trend suddenly stop. Instead, I think Blender is here to stay and grow. Just few years ago, I was talking with my professional friend. He was doing an Iron Sky mobile game, and he was asking me to model and render a rotating comet 3D model for the game, so that the spaceship would try to avoid collisions with the comets. When he first heard that I was going to do that with Blender, he was like, "You cannot do this kind of a professional tasks with Blender." But I did it with Blender and it came out to look quite nice, in my opinion. Let's go back to the search engine statistics for a while. There of course is more 3D modeling softwares than Blender and Max and Maya. Let's look another one which is called SolidWorks from company called Dassault Systems, and let's compare it with Blender. It seems that Blender is quite much as popular as SolidWorks today. But the thing is that SolidWorks and Blender are not exactly the same kind of softwares. They are both for 3D modeling, yes, but Blender is for artistic modeling and SolidWorks is for product design, and the approach of both programs is completely different. Blender also is not currently a CAD software, even though I know that Blender Foundation has plans to start slowly implementing CAD kind of features to Blender. Blender is supposed to be later also more non-destructive than what it's now, but those are things in the future. Why these statistics mean anything is because most of the traffic is coming from the students and people who are interested of 3D modeling. They are the future professionals, and if they start with Blender in the future, they are also maybe going to stay with Blender. It's not anymore that you have to select some specific software to be able to do some tasks that only can be done with that specific software. There are so many alternatives to every 3D related tasks, and it's up to you which one you select. Nowadays, you take the software you like and do the task with that. For many people, it means Blender for many tasks because they don't like complex terms of use agreements, or they don't like expensive licenses, and also they don't like subscription models. So, those were my reasons why I believe that Blender is slowly taking the market of 3D modeling. It's already taking over many of the artistic modeling tasks, but then somewhere in future there might be a chance that Blender will also start eating the revenue from CAD software houses. I'm not saying that Blender already can do everything its competitors can do. There are many areas where you need other softwares, especially when we talk about procedural modeling. But it seems very clear that Blender is going there also in future. But that's a completely different story. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have something to say, please add your comment below. It's very interesting to see what people think about this quite hot topic.